Watching media in your target language is one of the best ways to learn. In fact, it's core to the Refold method. But you can't just throw on a French show and hope to understand everything, right? The sentences go by too fast, rewinding is imprecise and kind of annoying, frankly, and you can't select the subtitles to copy and paste a word that you want to just look up. But all of this is fixed by using a meta layer. And today, I'm going to walk you through my favorite meta layer, ASBplayer. A meta layer, by the way, is just a tool that makes it a little bit easier to watch things. Some have a lot of features and bells and whistles, but what I like about ASBplayer is that it works with everything and is very simple. Let's start by looking at how to use and install it, and then we'll talk about why. First, you're going to want to go to the Chrome Web Store and search for ASBplayer, or you can click the link in the description. Then, click to add to Chrome. Sorry to all you Firefox users, but it's not currently available for you. If you use a browser like Edge or Brave or anything like that, this will work since those are all browsers that are based on the same technology as Chrome. If you're unsure what browser you have, just click on the button and it will tell you pretty quickly whether or not you can install it. Once you've added the extension, you'll see this page. If you'd like, you can read the README, but I'll cover most of the same things in this video. The first thing to show off is using it with media. It'll work on any website with a video player. I use it all the time for random Czech streaming sites that I watch shows on. But for right now, let's just use YouTube as an example since it's really common and we're on YouTube already. When you open a video, it'll look mostly the same, but if you press Ctrl+Shift+F, it'll look for the subtitle files. It might not automatically find them, especially for smaller sites, but for the popular ones like YouTube and Netflix, it should just show up. Here, I'm able to choose from the different subtitle files on this video. And then when I hit OK, it just displays them. Now, I can press down on my keyboard to show or hide those videos, right and left to go forward or back one subtitle line, and then up on the arrow keys will just replay that current subtitle line. Another really nice feature is auto pause, which you press Shift+P for, and that pauses after each subtitle line so that you have time to process what was said. I use this all the time for watching media. I just press play if I got it, or I rewind if I want to listen again. Shift+O will turn on condensed playback, which will skip the times when there's nobody talking. And the tick key, like right next to the number one on your keyboard, will open this sidebar, which is really nice if you want to follow along with everything that's going on, look backwards, look forwards, whatever it is. And then the last trick that I'll mention is you can speed up or slow down the playback. Ctrl+Shift+ and one of the square bracket keys either speeds up or slows down the content. This is great for re-listening to sections that are just a little bit too fast, or if you want to maybe skip through some fight scenes that you still want to see but you don't want to waste time on. If you ever need to see all of these options, you can click up here on the extensions, and then I suggest pinning the ASBplayer one, and then when you click, you can just see all the keyboard shortcuts in one space. You can also edit the appearance of your subtitles if you want. If you have some vision issues, you want them bigger or smaller or whatever reason, you can change the subtitles to be different colors and have different backgrounds, whatever it is. All these features that I mentioned require that you have subtitles. That's how the program knows when people aren't talking or what they're saying. Even if you have the subtitles hidden, the program still needs to have them. If you don't have subtitles for something and ASBplayer isn't automatically detecting them, I have a few videos on this channel about how to go about getting those subtitles. As an example, this Czech site that I use doesn't auto-detect subtitles, but I can download them directly by using a little hacker trick. Tutorial in the description. And then whenever you do have a subtitle file, you can just drag and drop that file on top of the video player and it will just import. Easy as that. If you absolutely cannot find subtitles for a piece of media, try complaining with the person that has that media and they might give you something, but not everything has them, even though that's a bummer. Another nice thing about ASBplayer is that you can select the subtitles. You can pretty easily copy and paste words into a dictionary to look things up. I have Vocab Civ installed, which can automatically look them up for me. Or if I turn on auto copy current subtitle to clipboard, each line will just show up in Vocab Civ and I can look them up that way. If you're studying a European language, watch my video on Vocab Civ. And if you're studying Japanese, Yomi-chan is your best option for this. Actually, I have another entire video about ASBplayer that shows off both of those different tools. Because ASBplayer has a ton of other features. I made a whole in-depth video about how to get those set up and all these different things for sentence mining, which is what we call it. You can find that link in the description. But the first couple minutes of the ASBplayer setup are out of date, so use this video instead of that. But the rest of the video is still very much good. But for now, if you're new to ASBplayer, I recommend that you just use it as it is. If you want to look up words, copy and paste them into the dictionary of your choice. It's pretty easy. And then, once you're comfortable with the program, go watch the video and consider adding some more complication to your setup. But for now, keep it simple. Now, I also promise to explain why ASBplayer is useful in the first place. The main reason I like it is because it adds quality of life to your content. The default fast-forward options are just like 5 or 10 seconds, which is pretty jumpy. But with ASBplayer, you can just move around based on what the characters are saying. It's so much easier to replay lines, phrases, or even go back to the beginning of a scene and not interrupt your immersion as much by trying to find that exact point. It's also insanely useful for doing intensive immersion. That means you're focused in on new things and looking up words or phrases. Autopause is invaluable for this, and so is being able to copy the subtitles. I don't know why that's not a default option for like everything. And this whole concept of working with your immersion materials is what makes the Refold method. In our experience, actually putting that extra brain power behind your immersion is what helps you improve a lot more rapidly. And that's a lot harder to do without tools like this. ASBplayer also works really well with other programs because it's so simple. I didn't go into that a ton in this video, but the fact that it works on basically any random website is really useful. When you're learning a less popular language, it can be hard to find media on the main streaming sites. Like I said, I use it all the time to watch my random Czech TV shows on sites like Prima Plus and Česká televize. Anyway, I'll leave it here for now. I hope this tutorial helped you in your language learning journey. If you want to learn more about ASBplayer, check the links in the description and please don't forget to subscribe. I'll catch you in the next video. Happy immersing. I'm here to drop some knowledge, listen up with your ears. I got a language learning method, gonna make it crystal clear. Call Refold the game changer, gonna blow your mind. Immerse yourself in media, fluency you will find.